ನಾಪಿ ಅಕೃತ ಅಭ್ಯಾಗಮಾದಿ ದೋಷದ್ವಯಂ. ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ಸೊ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಕ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ದ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಕ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡನ್, ಆರ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಡಿಪ್ರೈವ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್, ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಾದೃಶ್ಯ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಯಸ್ಯ ಶೃಂಖಲಾಸ್ಥಾನೇನ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಯನೈವ ಸೇತ್ಸ್ಯತಿ. ಇವನ್ ಸಾದೃಶ್ಯಂ ಸಿಮಿಲಾರಿಟಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರತ್ಯವಿಜ್ಞಾ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್, ಸಾದೃಶ್ಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಶೃಂಖಲಾ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರಿಲಿಯಂಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಗಿವ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ವ್ಯಪದೇಶ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಸಾದೃಶ್ಯ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಪ್ರತ್ಯವಿಜ್ಞಾ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್. ಇಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್. ವ್ಯಪದೇಶ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ಸಾದೃಶ್ಯ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಟು ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಸೀನ್. ಪ್ರತ್ಯವಿಜ್ಞ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಸಾ ಯೆಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ. ಪ್ರತ್ಯವಿಜ್ಞ ದೆನ್ ಆನಂದಗಿರಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೈನ್, ಅಪಸಿದ್ಧಾಂತ ಪ್ರಸತ್ಯ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಚಷ್ಟೇ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಶೃಂಖಲಾ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಒನ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ಸ್, similarly also if every a given cognition is connected to the previous cognition as well as the following cognition, then apasiddhant prasakti. Prasakti means prasanga. The occasion apasiddhant, that means you will be contradicting your own siddhanta of kshanikatvam. This momentariness that you so desire, this is such a desirable thing, momentariness. Everything is kshanikam, sarvam kshanikam kshanikam, sarvam dukkham dukkham, sarvam shunyam shunyam. So that kshanikatvam that is so desired, that itself will be contradicted. Na ityadi. So Vashyagana says in the second line, Na vartamana atitayoho bhinna kalatvad. Says, no, what you say is not tenable, it is not logical. ವರ್ತಮಾನ ಅತೀತಯೋ ಭಿನ್ನ ಕಾಲತ್ವಾತ್. ವರ್ತಮಾನ ದ ಕಾಗ್ನಿಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, ಅತೀತ ಬೋಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ಬೈ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯಟ್ ಟು ಕಮ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಕಾಗ್ನಿಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ಬೈ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಕಾಗ್ನಿಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಒಬ್ಟೇನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾಗ್ನಿಷನ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಟೈಮ್. So each cognition is independent and therefore each one is in its own time. Bhinna, bhinna kalatva. Then explains Vashyakara. Footnote 5 says, Sangrahitam vivranati tatraiti. So this is Sangrahavakya. Vartamana atitayoho bhinna kalatvaad. There is Sangraha Vakya, which means in brief, Vashyakara said, and then explains further. Tayoho pratyayoho madhye tyatatra means tayoho pratyayoho madhye. Vartamana kalika pratyaya, atita pratyaya. So tayoho madhye, among these two kinds of cognitions, tatra. So Vashyakara says, tatra vartamana pratyaya. ಏಕ ಶೃಂಖಲಾ ಅವಯವಸ್ಥಾನೀಯ ಅತೀತಶ್ಚ ಅಪರ ತೌ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಯೌ ಭಿನ್ನ ಕಾಲೌ ತದುಹ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಯ ವಿಷಯ ಸ್ಪೃಕ ಚೇದ್ ಶೃಂಖಲಾ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಯ ತತಃ ಕ್ಷಣದ್ವಯ ವ್ಯಾಪಿತ್ವಾದ ಏಕಸ್ಯ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಸ್ಯ ಪುನಃ ಕ್ಷಣವಾದ ಹಾನಿ. ತತ್ರ ವರ್ತಮಾನ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಯ ಏಕ ಶೃಂಖಲಾ ಅವಯವ ಸ್ಥಾನೀಯ. ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ that vartamana, the present cognition of an object, is vartamana pratyaya, pratyaya cognition. Ekaha shunkhala avayavasthaniya. Look upon this as a one cognition in place of a link in the chain, shunkhala avayava. Shunkhala means a chain. avayava is its part. Here is its link. Shrinkhala avayava sthaniya. Now footnote number 6. Uvayatra anvayidam. Shrinkhala avayava sthaniya. Atitascha aparaha shrinkhala avayava sthaniya. So, one cognition is like a link. The second one also is a link. Atitascha aparaha. In the second cognition, subsequent, the previous cognition is different. The following cognition also is different. Each link is different. Tau pratyayo bhinna kalau. Both these pratyas, the previous one as well as the present one, are bhinna kalau. They must necessarily be in separate, different kala. See, for me to say that this is one moment, and a second moment, and third moment, the one moment must have come to end, and the second moment must arise. For us to count something like that, it is necessary that they must be distinct. That one moment must have gone, must have concluded, the second moment must have arisen, and that must now subside, and the third moment must arise. Each moment should have an independent status, independent existence. Each moment must have a distinct existence, independent of the previous and the following one. So, pratyau bhinna kalau. Both these cognitions are bhinna kalau. The previous one and the present one, they obtain at different times. What does Anandagiri say? Tau eva uhau yau pratyau vishayau tad avagahi chet madhyavarti shrinkhala avayavasthaniha pratyahiti yavada. So tad ubhaya pratyaya vishaspruk chet shrinkhala pratyaya. Tad ubhaya pratyaya vishaspruk. Previous pratyaya, previous cognition has a subject matter, present cognition has a subject matter, following cognition has a subject matter. Previous cognition I saw this part, present cognition I say this part, next cognition I may see yet something else. So let us talk of the previous and the present one, ubhaya. Tat ubhaya pratyaya vishaya. The previous part A is a vishaya, the object of the previous cognition. This part B is the object of the present cognition. Vishaspruk chet shrinkhala pratyaya. If you have to say that the cognition of this part is pruk, it touches, is connected, you know, in some ways with the previous cognition. Tataha kshanadvaya vyapitvat. That means that this cognition which takes place now is connected to the previous cognition, the previous kshana also. And also is connected to the next kshana. There is one cognition, therefore, pervades the previous moment as well as next moment. That means it is more, it is longer than one moment. The idea is that kshanadvaya vyapitvat. That it must actually persist for two moments. Ekasya vijnanasya punah kshanavadahani. And then, for you to say that every cognition is just momentary, that is contradicted by accepting that this cognition was connected to the previous one. That means every cognition must stretch for at least two moments and then go away. And then two moments. If two moments, one or three moments. And if two moments means dimension, understand. One moment means no dimension. So as long as it is momentary, that means that since moment does not have a dimension, therefore you would accept that it is momentary. So when you say that a thing lasts for two moments, then two moments of a time a length. If it can have a length, then why not it can have any length, you see? If it doesn't have a length, then it doesn't have at all. But if it does have some length of two moments, then it will have a length of third moment also, and then kshana vadahani. So Anandagiri says, tau ev uhau yo pratyau vishayau tad avagahi ched. So the previous cognition and the present cognition, each cognition has a content and an object or some. And tat avagahi chet madhyavarti shrinkhala avayavasthaniha pratyaya. With the middle cognition, which is the, like a link, if avagahi, that means that it objectifies the previous one also and this one also, then this is the problem that every cognition will lasting for two moments, and that would contradict the momentariness of the cognition. देन आनंद गिरी क्षणानाम मिथ संबंध स्तर हिमाभूत मोमेंट यू फाइंड दैट वन क्षण इज कनेक्टेड टू अनदर क्षण देन एवरी क्षण लास्ट फॉर टू क्षण देन क्षण क्षणिकवाद हानि देन ही सेज क्षणानाम सो फुटनोट अटेंड क्षणिकानाम प्रत्ययानाम ऑल राइट द प्रत्यय द कॉग्निशन दैट टेक्स प्लेस एवरी मोमेंट क्षणानाम मिथ संबंध तर ही माभूत then let these two moments not be connected. Iti chetatraha mama iti. Then Mahashyakara continues, mama tavare vishesha anupattescha sarva vyavahara lopa prasangaha. Mama Tava, footnote number 7, mama ityadi, mama tava vyavaharasya sambandhasakatvad iti bhavaha. To say mine, yours, that's another thing, you know. To say that this is my book. Now, when you say it is my book, that means that this book is connected to something, you know. My book meaning a book connected to me. Now for me to say this is my book, there must be a cognition of I as well as this book. That means that this presently I see the book. For me to call it my book, there must be the cognition of this book must be connected with I for me to say my book. Or this is your book. For that there must be at least two cognitions. You is one cognition, book is another cognition. Both of them must be connected for us to say this is your book. So that's what footnote number 7 says. Mama tava vyavaharasya. This vyavahara, this vyavahara means shabda prayoga, to say mine and yours, even this much. Sambandha sakatvar. Mama also is sambandha, connected with I. Tava also is sambandha, connected with you. Sambandha means that pratyaya is ubhaya avagahi. It must have this, to say my book, then that cognition of mine is connected to I as well as book. That means that cognition must connect the two. Think of painting at different times. So mama tavai vishesha anupattesha. You can't say this. I can say some. This also I can't. I can just see. But I cannot say mine. Because for me to say mine, this must be connected to I. For me to say this yours, it must be connected to you. In short, this is stupid, you know, to accept. This is sadhika avijnanam. You cannot explain it vyavahara at all. And so to insist, the insistence upon kshanikatvam is to become detached from that, you know. So in order to create detachment, you call it kshanika. But then by calling it, let there be some better way of detachment, you know, rather than just calling it kshanika. That is impermanent, therefore you should not be connected. Well, let it be permanent, it still need not be connected, you know. So accept for what it is and then find out a better reason as to why a person should not be connected. Don't say it is dukkham, dukkham. Vedanta doesn't say saram dukkham. Doesn't say saram kshanikam. Saram shunyam Vedanta doesn't say. Vedanta does not say everything is dukkha. Vedanta says you just don't know how to deal with things, that is why dukkha is there, you know. Otherwise there is no dukkha. And so, this dukkha is purely created by the individual. It doesn't have any objective reality. When you say sarvam dukkha, meaning you are giving some reality to that, you know, that everything is dukkha. There is no dukkha. And so, nāna shochanti pandita, there is no shoka at all. It is purely product of ignorance. Ignorance goes away, let everything be what it is. And still there need not be dukkha. So that is the way, this is, in this way, no vyavahara can be explained at all. And still they accept the vyavahara. And still they insist upon this. Okay. So, mamatavadi vishesha anupattescha siranagiri vyapadesha sadrushya pratya anupattistu sita evaidi chakarataha. Already vyapadesha ghata you cannot say. Sadrushya similar ghata also you cannot say. There has been a step. Further, you cannot even say mine, yours, this comes sambandha. Sambandha always requires a linking of two. And linking of two cannot be because every moment is independent. Because one moment is not connected to the other moment, and therefore sambandha is not possible. So chakara means what? Anupattescha, this further anupatti, then mamatama vyavahara also will not be possible. Sarva vyavahara lopa prasangaha, in that case, there will be cessation of any kind of shabda prayoga. No shabda prayoga, you can't say anything, that's all. Because you, how can you say? For me to say hina, then, you know, how can I say that? How do I give that name? Because I must have the previous, cognition to connect, to say anything. So no word can be used, because for using the word, there must be continuity from the past, that's all. To use any word, there must be continuity from the past. And since continuity is not accepted, therefore, you cannot say table, you can't say anything. Because I've never seen a clock. Now I'm arising at this moment, and then clock, everything is new to me. Then I'm gone before I gain experience, again another fellow arises, and therefore, no vyavahara, no shabda prayoga of any kind is possible. Sarva vyavahara lova prasanga. Then, shapta vijnanasya dukkhadi upaplutatvam. That's another thing. Yattu vijnanasya dukkhadi upaplutatvam. That's footnote number 11. Dukkhadi samsarga iti bhavah. Sarvam dukkham dukkham. Sarvam kshanikam kshanikam. That vijnanam is characterized by being kshanikam. And then there is also characterized by being dukkham, that this person is to be liberated because he is dukkhi. That means this kshanika vijnana or momentary consciousness is connected or is characterized by, qualified by dukkham, dukkhitvam. So yattu vijnana is dukkhadi adi. Adi means kshanikatvam, dukkhatvam. So dukkhadi upaplutatvam. So upaplava. Upaplava means being attacked by that. In this case, upaplutatvam, that means that it is attacked by being painful or unhappy, unhappiness. So upadrava, upaplutatvam. Dukkhadi dharmitvam, all that, yeah. Dukkhadi dharmitvam. That vijnanam is characterized by dukkhi. So it is dukkhi. Saram dukkham. It is kshanikam. So kshanikatva becomes its dharma. Dukkhi, then dukkha becomes its dharma. So dukkhadi dharmitvam. To call it this kshanik vijnanam is dukkhi. And then to release him from dukkha. Because a person who is liberated also is a kshanika. He is dukkhi. So yattu vijnanasya dukkhadi upaplutatvam taddushayati sarvasyachayati. And so that also is faulted here, sarvasyachayati. Sarvasyacha swasamvedya vijnana matratve vijnanasya cha svachya avabodha avabhasa matra swabhavya abhyupagamat taddarshinascha anyasya abhave anitya dukkha shunya anatmatvadi aneka kalpana anupapattihi. Sarvasya cha jagataha, footnote number 8, sarvasya cha jagataha, an entire creation, cha swasamvedya vijnana matratve. He says that every moment a ghata arises and ghata reveals itself. So everything is self-revealing. This is the idea. Or everything knows itself, self-reveals. Everything reveals itself. So sarvasya cha jagataha swasamvedya vijnana matratve. What is the jagat of the universe is nothing but this self-revealing consciousness, momentary consciousness. And then what does it say? Vijnanasya cha svachya avabodha avabhasamatra swabhavya abhyupagamad. Abhyupagama, what is it that you accept in your siddhanta? Swabhavya, this is the nature of vijnana. What is the nature? Svachya avabodha avabhasamatra. The avabodha is knowledge. consciousness. Svachha. Svachha means it is placid, transparent, so pure. So svachha avabodha avabhasamata svabhavya. That this universe that you see is nothing but a reflection of or abhasa or appearance of the vijnanam. Vijnanam which itself is pure, placid. You know, svachha avabodha is pure vijnanam. And whatever you see is nothing but the appearance of that vijnanam. So svachha avabodha avabhasamata svabhavya abhivagamat. This is what you accept. That whatever it is, nothing but the vijnanam alone, vijnanam, the consciousness in itself, is pure. And that alone appears as all of this. So all there is nothing but this vijnanam. In short, what they say, subject, object, all of this is nothing but one vijnanam. Which vijnanam is svachha, avabodha, that's all. So that vijnanam alone revealing itself as this drashtana drishya, that is all that is. Tad darshinascha anyasya abhave. Tad darshina. Vijnane dukkhadi samsarga darshina. Now who is? The point is, if dukkha etc. of kshanikatva, the thing is, if momentariness is the very nature of vijnanam, dharma of the vijnanam, then you cannot see your own dharma. The idea is that in order for you to see something, it must be different from you. The seer must be different from the seen. So, tad darshinascha anyasya abhave. The one who sees the dukkhitvam of the vijnanam, the kshanikatvam of the vijnanam, shunyatvam of the vijnanam, so that person is not there. You can't ride your own soul, that means that you cannot objectify yourself. Tad darshinascha anyasya abhave. Anitya dukkha shunya anatmatvadi. To say everything is kshanikam anitya dukkham. So jagat is what? Kshanikam. Jagat is what? Dukkham. Jagat is anatma. That is how jagat has been dismissed. That is how you must give it up. That's all. Some kind of a dvesha for jagat, you know. So everything is kshanikam, dukkham, impermanent, shunyam, anatma. Anek kalpana anupattihi. Therefore, the vijnanam cannot objectify vijnanam, therefore there is no one to objectify its own dharma. So how can you even say that it is anatma, or dukkhi, or kshanikam, or shunyam? How can you say that? Anandagiri says, shuddhutvat tat samsarga drashtru abhavaccha na jnanasya dukkhadi samplavaha. The two reasons. Shuddhutvat. That is called Shuddha, the pure, which is unconnected to impurity. On one hand, for you to say that Vijnanam is Shuddham. On the other hand, for you to say that Shuddha, the pure Vijnanam is in any way, is in some way connected to or is attacked by Dukkhitvam, Kshanikatvam, etc. So, Shuddhatvam and Dukkhitvam do not go together. Shuddhatvam and impermanence also do not go together. So for you to say that on one hand Vijnanam is Shuddham, on the other hand for you to say that there is Dukkhitvam, that this fellow is Dukkhi and he must be made Sukhi. So Dukkhitvam and Shuddhatvam, they do not go together. Shuddhatvat and Tat Samsarga Drashtu Abhavacha. And also this Vijnanam and Dukkhitvam are connected. Then you can call it Dukkhi Vijnanam. So Vijnana and Dukkha are connected. There must be someone who sees them together. Vijnanam and Dukkha are seen together, then alone we can say that Vijnanam is Dukkhi. See, for example, for us to say that the rose is red, let us say, then there must be a person who sees both rose as well as red and sees them in one location for that person to say the rose is red. So also for one to say that Vijnanam is Dukkhi, then one must see Vijnanam as well as Dukkha connected to each other, then alone one can say that Vijnanam is characterized by Dukkha. So Vishesha, Visheshana, the substantive and the adjective, both of them must be seen in one place for us to say that this is red flower. So flower and red, both of them must be seen by someone to say that this is red flower. So also that Vijnanam and Dukkha, both of them must be seen by someone for us to say that Vijnanam is Dukkhi. But tat samsarga drashtu abhavat. But who will see that? So, Vijnanam is alone there. Vijnanam cannot see Vijnanam. So, सत्तत संसर्ग दृष्टो अभावाच न ज्ञानस्य दुःखादि संप्लवः दुःखादि संसर्गः. Therefore you cannot establish that the jnanam is in any way connected with dukkham or kshanikam etc. स्वसंवेद्यत्व अंगीकारादित्यर्थः. Footnote 14. दुःखादि संप्लवः संबंधः. 14. तस् संसर्ग दृष्टोभाव हेतुमाह स्वसंवेद्यत्व अंगीकारादिति तथा च ज्ञानस्य स्वमात्र भासकत्वं न तु स्व आश्रित भासकत्वम् इति. सो ज्ञानम कैन ओनली रिवील इटसेल्फ बट इट कैन नॉट रिवील दुःख व्हिच इज डिपेंडेंट अपॉन दैट. स्वसंवेद्य ज्ञानम नोज इटसेल्फ. सी ज्ञानम इज सेड टू बी स्वसंवेद्य मीनिंग सेल्फ नोइंग. नाउ ज्ञानम इज प्योर. So jnana will know itself as pure. If you say that dukkha is somehow connected with jnanam, ashritam, so jnanam becomes locus of dukkha, that's how you call jnanam as dukkhi. But jnanam only can reveal itself, cannot reveal dukkha which is dependent upon that. Swasamvedyatam means everything reveals itself, cannot reveal anything else. Everything reveals itself, a thing cannot reveal other things. Now jnanam is one, dukkha is its dharma, or dukkha is its adjective, attribute. Attribute is different from the substantive. So jnanam which is substantive reveals itself, but it cannot reveal dukkha. Now dukkha can reveal itself, but cannot reveal anything else. But then jnanam and dukkha, both of them are self-revealing, all right. But who will establish connection between them? Jnanam is self-revealing, all right, as revealing as pure consciousness. Dukkha is self-revealing as revealing itself as dukkha. But jnanam cannot reveal dukkha, and dukkha cannot reveal jnanam, because it is svasamvedyatvam na parasamvedyatvam. That being the case, who will now reveal jnanam and dukkha together to arrive at the conclusion that the dukkha is connected, jnanam is connected, jnanam is dukkhi? See, this is a very subtle point. So jnanasya svamatra bhasakatvam na tu sva ashrita bhasakatvam. If you accept this rose and the color as two different entities and say that the rose is red, then rose will reveal itself as rose and red reveals itself as red. But then the red rose cannot, you know, so red is different and rose is different. Each one reveals itself. But there must be someone who connects the two and sees the rose and red in one place, then alone one can say that this is a red rose. So sukta vijnanam, kshanika vijnanam reveals itself and dukkha reveals itself, there must be yet another sakshi to see kshanikam as well as dukkham together for him to say that this dukkha kshanika is dukkhi. We don't accept a sakshi beyond the vijnanam. If you accept, then it's all right. Their vijnanam is our mind, and mind and dukkha can be seen together by sakshi. Then it's okay, but they don't accept that. तो शुद्धत्वात् तत्संसर्ग दृष्टु अभावाच्च शुद्धत्वात् आल्सो. सो इन व्हिच केस स्वसंवेद्यत्वम इज ए हेतु. इट इज शुद्धम, देयरफॉर इट कैन रिवील इटसेल्फ एज शुद्धम. हैड इट बीन अशुद्ध, इट विल रिवील इटसेल्फ एज अशुद्ध. सो शुद्ध, देयरफॉर रिवील इटसेल्फ एज अशुद्ध एंड कैन नॉट रिवील दुख. एंड तत्संसर्ग दृष्टु अभावाच्च दुख रिवील्स इटसेल्फ, बट देयर इज नो दृष्टा हु सीज द क्षणिक विज्ञानम एंड दुख and connects them. Thus samsarga drashtu abhavaccha na jnanasya dukkhadi samplavaha. Therefore you cannot establish the connection of jnanam with dukkham for you to say that this person is dukkhi. Okay, so this far we came. Now continuing next page. ज्ञानस्य शुद्ध बोधेक स्वाभाव्यम असिद्धम. ज्ञानस्य शुद्ध बोधेक स्वाभाव्यम. द ज्ञान इज शुद्ध बोध एक स्वभाव. शुद्ध बोध प्योर अवेयरनेस, मीन जस्ट प्योरली अवेयरनेस, नथिंग एल्स. असिद्धम, ही सेज नो, वी डोंट से दैट नॉलेज इज मियरली, आई मीन प्योर कॉन्शियसनेस. दाढ़िमादिवत नानाविध दुखादि अंशवत्व आश्रयणादि आशंक्या है दाढ़िमा इज प्रोमिंग्रेनेट यू नो दैट इज दाढ़िमा सो दाढ़िमादिवत लाइक ए प्रोमिंग्रेनेट एनीवे वी यूज्ड टू हैव वन सो इवन दिस थिंग व्हाट इट इज आल्सो कैन बी सेड टू बी दैट यू नो सो सो नानाविध दुखादि अंशवत्व आश्रयणाद So this Dadima, what is happening to Dadima here? so Dadima Falasya Madhurya Kututvadikam Amshabhedena. See, one part of this pomegranate tastes sweet, other part tastes bitter. So its peel would taste bitter and then Dadima itself would taste sweet and then whatever it is. You know? So, how one dadima has so many avayavas are there. So simultaneously it is sweet also, it is bitter also. So how in one pomegranate you have all this? You cannot say pomegranate is sweet. It is mixed up. It is sweet also as well as it is bitter also and whatever other kind of tastes are there, you know. So all of that is in one pomegranate. so dadima adivat nanaveda dukkhadi amshavattu ashrayanat. Just as one pomegranate fruit is ashraya, is a locus of various elements, each one tasting somewhat different. Similarly also we say that vijnanam is an ashraya, locus of these various kinds of dharmas like dukkhitvam, kshanikatvam, shunyatvam, etc. In case they say that, iti ashankyaha, so our vijnanam is like this, then Says Vashyakara, Nacha Dadima Dehe Iva Viruddha Anekam Shavatvam Vijnasya Swachh Avabhasa Swabhavyad Nacha, and again you cannot say that Dadima Dehe Iva. So like this pomegranate fruit, viruddha anek amshavatvam, all viruddha things can remain in one locus. In one fruit, all the opposite tastes can remain, similarly also vayanod and vijnanam, the consciousness, all this dukkhitvam, kshanikatvam, all of these can, vijnanam can become ashraya of all these various attributes or characteristics. Iti ashankshu nacha dadima deheva. Viruddha anekamshavatvam vijnanasya. So vijnana is dukkha, sukhadi, aneka, sometimes sukhi, sometimes dukhi, always viruddhamsa can remain in vijnanam. So this is not possible. Svachh avabhasa svabhava, because you claim that vijnanam is pure, and placid, and therefore that which is pure or placid cannot become the locus of various impurities. See that, what that is called pure, which is free from impurity. Whatever we say is pure, that means it is free from impurity, that means impurity must always remain a foreign element for us to call water as pure, as Bhashyakara himself will explain. Svach avbhasa swabhavyat putnar one, tvaya etatche abhivagama, tvaya evat tatha abhivagama, tvaya evat tatha abhivagama. Because this is what you yourself say, that vijnanam is ever pure. Then says, ane tatreva hetvantramaha tatreva tasya viruddha anekam sattva asambhave eva. That how one vijnanam cannot become the locus of the contradictory attributes, there another hetu, another reason is being stated, anityadi. Anitya dukkhadinam vijnanam shatvecha stati anuhuyamanatvad vyatirikta vishayatva prasangah. Anitya dukkhadinam vijnanam shatve sarvam kshanikam kshanikam sarvam dukkham dukkham Saram shunyam shunyam. This is sutra. Saram kshanikam kshanikam. Saram dukkham dukkham. Saram Shunyam Shunyam. This is how. So this is what they find in Vijnanam. So Bodhanam, Saram Kshanikam, Saram Dukkham, Shunyam, Mityari Pratyaya, Anitya Dukkhadinam, Vijnanam Sattve. If you say that Anityatva, Dukkhya, Dukkhat, etc., all of the Amsha, all of these are the, all of the fractions of Vijnanam. Tathāca sati, if this is so, anubhūyamānatvāt, there must be someone who sees this kṣaṇikatvam. Someone who knows kṣaṇikatvam, someone who knows dukkhitvam, someone who knows śūnyatvam. So vyatirekta viṣayatva prasangah. Then there must be someone who is seer of these things. That is what you will accept. Because they don't accept it, they say it is self-revealing, but we say that vijñānam reveals itself, dukkhitvam reveals itself. Then therefore, both of them can reveal themselves, but how? You must have a seer who sees both vijñānam and dukkhitvam for you to say that. And of course, here they have accepted for a moment that vijñānam itself is locus of this contradictory attributes. If vijñānam is the locus of contradictory attributes, then also there is someone who sees this vijñānam with attributes, then alone you can establish that vijñānam is kṣaṇikam and dukkham. And so, vyatirekta viṣayatva prasangah. Anandagiri says, Tesham tad dharmatve, Tesham, footnote number 7, Anitya dukkhadinam, tad dharmatve, vijnana dharmatve. If you say that impermanent, kshanikatvam, dukkhitvam, etc. are all vijnana dharma, they are all the dharma, the attributes of vijnanam, the consciousness, tad dharmatve sati anubhuyamanatvat. That means that there is someone who experiences that kshanikam, kshanikatvam, dukkhatvam, etc., dukkhitvam, etc. Tataha atiriktatvam syat. Anubhuyamanatvat tataha atiriktatvam syat. Footnote number 9. Vijnanataha tataha means vijnanataha. There must be someone who is different from vijnanam to see all these different attributes of vijnanam. Dharmanam dharimatratva abhavat. See, dharma and dharmiya are accepted as separate. That flower is accepted as different from the color. So dharmanam dharimatratva abhavat. You can't say the red color is flower alone. Red is different and flower is different. Because flower can be yellow also, white also, and red also, and therefore you can't say that dharma is a dharmi. The red color is a flower, flower is a dharmi, red is dharma. So dharmanam dharimatratva abhavat. So goodness cannot be the person. Person is one, goodness is another thing. So mayanam cha manad arthandratvat. Also mayam, the object is different from the means revealing the object. So my eyes are the pramanam, and this flower is the prameya object. So mayanam cha manad arthandratvat. You would accept that the object of perception is different from the means of perception. Ataha yanmayam natad jnanam saha. Therefore, whatever is perceived, so it's different from the knowledge which illumines that. Therefore, what is perceived cannot be amsha. See, the thing is that if you say that vijnanam is possessor of kshanikatvam, then kshanikatvam becomes a mayam. Kshanikatvam becomes the object of knowledge because it is known. And if it is object of knowledge, then the knowledge which reveals that must be different from the object of knowledge, just as pramanam. Pramanam means the knowledge. See, the vritti. Let's say this vritti or pushpakarvati, the vritti of the nature of flower, is that which reveals the flower, has to be different from flower. So, mayana, mana, arthantaratva, the object is different from the means of the object. Yan mayam. So, if jnanam is that which reveals the object, then object is different from jnanam, therefore, yan mayam, natad jnanam saha. So dukkhitvam also is known, so dukkhitvam also is revealed. So dukkhitvam also is revealed by vijnanam. So vijnanam becomes a pramanam, dukkhitvam becomes the prameyam, and prameya and pramana being different, the vijnanam and the dukkha must be different. Yan mayam natad jnanam saha. So dukkhitvam, kshanikatvam, etc. cannot be amsha because they are maya, because they are known. Therefore they cannot be amsha, they are part of the same jnanam, because jnanam is what reveals them. Yatha ghatadi, just as ghatapata, etc. are all revealed by the means of knowledge, and they must be different from them. Mayam cha dukkhaditya sa, so dukkhadi etc. is mayam, as we say. So atiriktatvam syat. In short, therefore, this dukkha etc. must be different from vijnanam. The idea is that vijnanam is that which reveals the dukkha. So that which is revealed must be different from the one that reveals. So dukkha etc. revealed by vijnanam, then they must be separate from vijnanam, they can only be part of vijnanam. Therefore it is said vijnanta atiriktatvam syat. You should accept that this dukkhitvam, kshanikatvam etc. will have to be different from vijnanam. Because vijnanam is that which reveals them. And therefore they are maya. Vijnanam is pramana. And so jnanam must be different from mayam. Therefore they cannot be, so dukkhitva etc. cannot be part of the vijnanam. So this is it. If you accept the dukkhadinam vijnanam sattva or vijnana dharmatva, if you say the dukkhitva etc. dharma of the vijnanam, revealed by vijnanam, then what is revealed by vijnanam is separate from vijnanam, therefore that cannot be part of vijnanam. Then says here Anandagiri, jnanasya dukkhadi dharmo na bhavati. Says, well, we don't say that dukkha etc. is dharma of the jnanam. Then what is it? Kintu swarupamevaiti. But dukkha is the very nature of jnanam. That's another, then you are landing in a big trouble. To say that even dukkha is the attribute of jnanam itself is a problem. But to say that dukkha is the very nature of jnanam. Jnanasya dukkhadi jnanasya dharmo na bhavati kintu swarupamevaiti. Shankam anubhasya doshamaha. So reiterating that shanka, then the dosha, the defect involved in the idea is being stated atha ityadina. Atha anitya dukkhadyatmakatvam eva vijnanasya tada tadviyogat विशुद्धि कल्पना अनुपत्ति ही अच्छा फुटनोट नंबर 3 अच्छा सो विज्ञानस्य नो फुटनोट नंबर 2 दुखादि वियोगात नो सो या फुटनोट नंबर 2 अच्छा दुखादि वियोगात सो anitya dukkhadyatmakatvam eva vijnanasya. All right. So, on the other hand, if you accept that anityatvam, dukkham, etc. is the very swarupa of vijnanam, then tada tadviyogat vishuddhikalpana anupattihi. Tad means dukkha. That footnote number 2 means tadviyogat. So, dukkhadiviyogat. It must be shifted there. So, tada tadviyogat. Dukkhad vyogat vishuddhi kalpana vijnana vishuddhi kalpana. That's how footnote number 3 vijnanasya vishuddhi kalpana anupattihi. The thing is that, as Vashyakara explained, if you say that dukkha is the very nature of vijnanam, then you can never get rid of dukkham from vijnanam, because tad vyogat, you cannot separate the very swarupa from the thing. So tad vyogat vishuddhi kalpana anupattihi. Because this is the very swabhava. Ni swabhava bhavanam vyavartate. That's what Bhashyakara explains. Anupatti meva prakatayati. That very untenability is revealed here by Bhashyakara. Sanyogi. Sanyogi malavyogadhi vishuddhir bhavati yatha आदर्श प्रभृतीनां नतो स्वाभाविके धर्मेण कस्यचित् वियोगो दृष्टः नहि अग्नेः स्वाभाविकेन प्रकाशेन औष्ण्येन वा वियोगो दृष्टः. So if you accept that dukkha is the very nature of vijnanam, then you can never imagine vijnanam as separate from dukkham. Just as you say that Svachata is the nature of Vijnanam, Vijnanam always Svachya. You say Svasamvedyatvam, self-reveningness is the nature of Vijnanam, it always is self-revening. Similarly also if Dukkha is the nature of Vijnanam, it always is Dukkham, Dukkhi. You cannot separate the Swarupa from itself because then it won't remain. So, as Vashyakara says, Nahi agnehe swabhavikena aushnena prakashena aushnena va. Prakasha, the light is the nature of fire and heat is the nature of fire. You cannot take away fire, heat or light from the fire because there will be no fire. There will be no fire at all. So agnehe agnitvam. So what is it? Apagat agnehe agnitvam. Vacharambhanam vikaronamdham etc. So agni is made of this. You remove that, there is no agni at all. So sanyogi malayoga devishuddhir bhavati. If mala or impurity is something that is somehow associated, then by disassociation you can purify something. Just as the water is happens to be associated with impurity, impurity is still foreign, not part of water, but associated with water, then you can remove and purify the water. So sanyogi mala vyoga adhi vishuddhir bhavati. So by separation of impurity that has somehow come in association, so by separation of that impurity, you can purify something. Yatha adarsha prabhutinam. Bhashyakara gives the example of a mirror. Just as surface of the mirror has become very dusty, and so you can remove the dust because the dust is not the part of the mirror, dust is not mirror. So impurity is not water, therefore you can remove that. Even disease can be removed from the body if it is not part of the body. If it is foreign, you can get rid of it. If it is nature of the body, you cannot. So whatever is the nature of the body, you can't change it. Whatever is in agantoka, so that can be removed. Suppose I want to say I want to change my height. You can't do that because it's part of the, or whatever are the basic fundamental characteristics, you cannot change. But whatever is congenital, you can't change. But you can change something that is agantoka. If congenital you can change, that means that is also agantuka. That's for the next point, you know. If you can change the swabhavikena dharmena kasyatit viyoga drishtah. We never find that a thing can be disassociated with its own nature. Nahi agnehi swabhavikena prakashena aushnena viyoga drishtah. We cannot see that agni can be in any way disassociated with heat or light. We cannot see that. Now an experience of how we can see. Like this flower, this red flower, can lose its color. Now, redness is the nature of flower. Still, it can lose its redness. This cloth is orange. It can lose its orange. So, orange is the nature of the cloth. And still, you can find that by coming in association with something, the cloth can lose its orangeness and can become white. Or can become something else. Although, white cloth can lose its whiteness and can become orange. So who says that one the nature cannot change? Cloth, white is the nature of the cloth. And now coming in contact with something the orange color, the cloth can become orange. That means that the cloth has given up its natural whiteness and become orange. Similarly in orange thing, this red flower, redness is its nature. And still when flower comes in contact with something, its color can change, you know, it can become white or it can become whatever. So that let me find. How do you say that the nature cannot change? That Anandagiri says, Swabhavikasyapi Vyoghasti. Footnote number 10, I guess. Swabhavikasyapi. See, footnote number Pushpasya Swabhavikavi Shaukliadihi. Shaukliya means whiteness. So let's say that a flower is white. Pushpasya. So स्वाभाविक अविशौक्ल्यादि द व्हाइट रेडनेस व्हाट एवर इट इज स्वाभाविक स्वभाव इज दैट व्हाइट कलर इज बोर्न विद द फ्लावर रेड कलर इज बोर्न विद द फ्लावर देयरफॉर यू कॉल इट स्वभाव यू नो सो दैट इज बोर्न विद इट सो सिंस दस फ्लावर इज व्हाइट सो पुष्पस्य स्वाभाविक अविशौक्ल्यादि अलक्तादि अलक्तादि रसावसिक्ते पुष्पवीपे ये अपगच्छति नाउ दिस दे वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट द हाइब्रिड थिंग हियर यू नो दैट इन द सीड ऑफ द फ्लावर इटसेल्फ इन द सीड ऑफ द फ्लावर कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद समथिंग अलक्त हियर मींस अ लैक यू नो रेड लैक लाक रेड लैक सो अलक्तादि रस अवसिक्ते दे मस्ट हैव अ प्रोसेस दैट There is a plant which gives rise to white flowers. You take the seed of the plant and somehow process it with this red lac. So rasa avastikte, in some way you can infuse this redness of the lac into the seed. Pushpa bivche apagachyati raga adischa utpadyate. And then what happens when that seed is then planted? And then the flower is red, so you find that. So they must have this process, they must have known this process of somehow hybrid thing, you know, of connect, joining the two and coming out of the third one anyway. So raga adishya utpadyate. No, you can't deny this because this is an they must have experienced this. Hybrid or whatever you want to call it. Somehow the seed which its nature it is to give rise to white flower, that seed can impregnated with some foreign element such as red, the atoms, atomic, you know, the red atoms of the color. And though they get impregnated in the seed and they get reflected into the very flower. This phenomenon they must have seen, otherwise you can't quote that here. So raga adishya utpadyate, that means that the flower has given up its whiteness, which is natural whiteness, and now the redness in the flower has come. So we find that the thing does give up its nature, and its nature can change. Rakta adishya utpadyate, sa vijnanasyapi, chaturvida bhavana prabhava. So vijnanam also bhavana prabhava. So vijnanam also can be impregnated, infused by this bhavana. Kshanikattvam, dukhittvam, shunyattvam, whatever the bhavana is. Chaturvidha bhavana prabhavat. Dukkhadi svabhavikam eva vijyate. Or the other way around. The vijnanam is dukkhi, kshanikam. Their bhavana. So whatever, so marga, whatever means that Buddha has taught as to how to purify yourself. Chaturvidha bhavana prabhavat. And so by that bhavana, dukkhadi svabhavikam eva vijyate. Just as whiteness, which is swabhav of the red, is somehow disassociated with the flower and the new nature, namely redness, comes, so also dukkhittvam, kshanikattvam, etc., which is the nature of vijnanam, can change by infusing this vijnanam by sudden bhavana, you know, by sudden sadhana. You can infuse the vijnanam and bring about a transformation in vijnanam. So, dukkhadi svabhavikam eva vyujyate. And so the nature of vijnanam, dukkhitvadi, it can be disassociated from that. Shuddhisya utpadyate. See, you can go to any length as far as argument is concerned. Now, he is willing to accept vijnanam is impure by nature. And by a certain process, or which is what you call spiritual sadhana, you can purify that vijnanam. Shuddhisya utpadyate, in abhipretya, these are all Jains, they believe that the Atma actually has become samsari. And by these spiritual practices, you have to purify the Atma. That the karma mala, the karma raja, the impurity of the karma actually sticks to Atma. So Atma becomes heavy and comes down to this world. And then by your spiritual sadhana, you must actually disassociate that karma. Then Atma will become light again and go to its loka. So therefore they accept an actual transformation. The Mimamsaka, everybody accepts. But we say that you cannot have transformation. Thing cannot give up its nature. And another thing is, if dukkha is the nature of the atma, you will have no problem with dukkha also, because everybody is comfortable with the natural thing also. Fire is comfortable with being hot. Fire is no problem being hot. Water has a problem. Because nature of water is cold, and therefore water has a problem in being hot, it will fight, it will struggle to become cold. Ice has no problem in being cold, because coldness is its nature, it's comfortable. So everything is always comfortable being what it is. Similarly also, if dukkha or unhappiness were the nature of vijnanam or the atma, then I would be comfortable with that. I'm not comfortable with dukkha. That shows that it cannot be my nature. This is the Vedantic argument. Here on the other hand, they say that I find myself dukkhi, that's why I'm dukkhi. And therefore the dukkhitva must be actually removed by a certain process. Shuddhischa utpadyate iti. This is how they say that the shuddhi is created. Thus vijnanam is purified. So svabhavikasyapi. So going back to Anandagiri, svabhavikasyapi vyoga asti. That even that is svabhavikam, there also you can bring about a disassociation with even one's own nature. Pushparaktatvadinam tatha upalambhat. So how pushparaktatvam? So pushpa shuklatvam. How pushpa shuklatvam? How the whiteness of the flower, we find that the viyoga disassociates whiteness and it becomes red. Pushparaktatvadinam tatha upalambhat dashanga yadapiti. So says Bhashyakara, yadapi pushpa gunanam raktatvadinam dravyantara yogena vyojanam dushyate tatrapi sanyoga purvatvam anumiyate bija bhavanaya pushpa phaladinam gunantarotpatti darshanat. So yadapi, even though pushpa gunanam raktatvadinam. So footnote verses shuklatvadinam ityartha. Because red is not made white. White is made red. Red may be also made white, who knows? But then, here the example that we read in the 10th footnote was white made red. That is why the footnote number 4 corrects it. Raktatvadinam says shuklatvadinam. So how whiteness etc. of the flower? Dravyantra sanyogena. So by the association, another dravya, in this case a red light. So some process must be there. Vyojanam drushyate. How that color which is natural to the flower also is disassociated with the flower? Vyojanam vibhagah drushyate. If this is so, if this flower can lose its red color, then we will say that redness is not its nature. That's all we will say. If the flower can change and become red, then we will say that redness also is agantuka. If whiteness of the flower can be converted into redness, we will say the whiteness is agantuka, redness also is agantuka. Then whatever is substance called flower is astraya locus of whiteness, now it has become locus of redness. That's what Bhashya, tatravi, vyojanam drushyate chet, tatravi, sanyoga purutam anuriyate. Then there also we infer that even that white color which has gone away also must be foreign, must be agantuka. So that also must have come because association is something. And therefore disassociation is possible. This is Buddha Sutra. Sarve sanyogaha vyogantaha. All sanyogas come to vyoga. Anything that goes up must come down. Anything that is associated must become disassociated. Therefore, give it up. So, why is it associated? Disassociation will come down. So forget about rising up and down. If you rise up, you are going to fall down. That's for vairagya. People must be really, at that time people must have required. If at that time they require, what talk of now? What will Buddha have to say when he comes now? I don't know. You know? At that time when the people are found to be so materialistic, what would they find it now? 100 years ago, Gandhi found that the whole world was tremendously corrupt, imagine, you know.
I think as though he would not even dream of what corruption can be. But in the early century, early 20th century, he found that Europe was corrupted. And so we don't want this corrupt kind of rule. We do not want India to be independent and being like Europe. I don't want another Europe, he says, in India. And we do not want to replace the rulers by skin. So white skin rulers go away and brown skin rulers come there. That is not Azad, that is not Swatantra, that is not freedom. Something must happen inside, that is called freedom, you know. So the idea is that even then also this was so clearly seen, you know. The corruption was so clearly seen. I knew that these fellows only replace them. You could see them, you know. These chairs will go. Something else will be established, people will remain what they are. So in name the country will be liberated, but in effect there is no liberation at all. So this is what we don't want that. So people must deserve, people must grow to become free. They cannot, the freedom cannot be a simply some kind of a physical material change. Freedom has to be an inner change. So this is how he could see that. But anyway, so here also tatrapi sanyoga purvatvam purvam anumiyate. And therefore, if this red color can change into white, then we will infer that even red also must be agantuka. We are quite happy with that. Ultimately, what is only one substance? Brahman is only substance. Everything is agantuka. Therefore, it can go. So Vedanta only keeps that in mind. What is the real substance according to Vedanta then is not flower, etc. Yastri Bhati Priyam, that is his substance. And he will not accept any attribute, etc. He will only say that everything else is Nam Rupa is what? Superimposed. Then everything is fine. What is superimposed alone can be removed, nothing else can be removed. If it is the slightest reality, it will stick to that. What is called Adhyaropa is that there is no reality at all. Snake has no reality, therefore, this snake can be, snakeness can be completely eliminated. So bad or complete elimination of snakeness is possible. Whatever real part is there, that will remain. I am Sarva, that I am part will remain. Only Sarva part, which is Brahma, that Brahma can be completely eliminated. That is why samsara can completely go only according to Vedanta. Because according to Vedanta, samsara is purely a product of Brahma, product of ignorance. And ignorance can be dispelled by knowledge. So for us, red and flower and everything is association, because only substance is asti bhati priyam. So tatravi sanyoga purvatam anumiyate. But all these arguments are coming to us only, that is all, anumiyate. So let us see, Anandaji says, dravyantara shabdena Pushpa sambandina avayavaha. What is dravyantara sanyoga? Now actually, when the flower becomes red, let us say originally it was white, and by processing the seed in some ways now, we have impregnated some red atoms into the, that's how, some kind of, they must have known the art of impregnation, you know. For example, the gold used to get impregnated on the copper or something like that, and then it would then remain. It's not superficial, it becomes part of it. Yeah, it's not plating, it becomes part of it. Impregnation. So that also they must have known in some way. To impregnate the seed, that is avayavantra, so dravyantara sanyoga. It is not really dravyantara in the sense, it becomes part of that only. Dravyantara shabdena pushpa sambandina avayavaha. Tadjad raktatvadi arambhakaha vivakshitaha. Footnote number 11. Raktatvadi vyojanaya. He skips on the, you know, raktatvadi vyojanaya. Pushpena sambandham lambhitaha avayavaha dravyantrasya eva. In short, whatever, let's say whiteness is nature of flower and some atoms come into the seed in order to disassociate the flower from whiteness and make it associated with the redness, then pushpena sambandham lambhitaha avayavaha. So now these avayava, meaning these red atoms, which have now gone into the seed and have now become part of the flower, they still, even though they appear to be part of the flower, they are only dravyantara. They are not flower, but they are only foreign element. This is what is meant by dravyantara sanyogena.
Tadgata raktadi arambhakaha.
Footnote number 12. Dravyantargata. So after 11, the footnote is 12. Dravyantargata raktatvedi. So tadgata means dravyantargata raktatvadi arambhakaha. And so those atoms then become the creators of the redness in the flower.
Vivakshitaha. I don't know what's so big deal about this, but anyway, there's a long discussion here, whatever it is. I am not going to worry about it. So, okay. Now, again, Anandagiri continues. Vimatam sanyoga purvakam. Vimatam vyuktam raktatvadi. Whatever, you know. So, sanyuktam ke vyuktam, whatever it is. So, anything that can be disassociated, sanyoga purvakam. So, viyuktam sanyogapurvakam, wherever viyoga happens, separation happens, understand that there was association, then alone, whenever disassociation is there, that means that there was an association and not oneness. Swami Dhyanaji, the friend has left you, then he was not the friend to begin with, you know. Because otherwise, when leaving happens, then the being one was not there, otherwise that separation cannot happen. So, with the fact that separation has happened, that means that oneness was not there to begin with. Then also there was some kind of a loose association, you know. That was there. That is how separation could happen. So, vimatam sanyoga purvakam vibhagatvat. Because it is disassociated, therefore, formally it was not a part of it, but it was only an association. Mesha divata. Now that's an interesting thing, you know. So, mesha divata. Iti. See, footnote 14, mesha divata. Viyujya, viyujya. Yudhyamana hudvadiva dityartha. See these rams, you know, or the sheep of the rams, the male sheep, ram. They, you know, they fight. When they fight, then their horns lock into one each other, you know, like that. Again they get together, again they fight, you know. So viyudhya viyudhya yudhyamana. Then they attack each other, you know, so. They take their position like that and then attack. Then association with some time. Then again. So disassociation, association. Disassociation, association. This is how it is. That's why this example, you know. So, viyujya viyujya yudhyamana hudvadivata. So, this is how, what an amount of thing must be there in there. What an amount of anger, whatever must be there. This gets up again. So, mesha divata. So, at one point you see that both these meshas are one, you know. They are so locked together, you know, fighting. Even fighting also they are locked over. They look one. Only when they separate to fight again, then you realize that they are separated, you know. But anyway, so, vimatam sanyogapuru vibhagatvat mesha divata. Is anumanat na swabhavikasya sati vastuni nasha asti ityartha. And therefore, whatever is swabhavikam, there cannot be disassociation. Where there is disassociation, there must be only association. This is the idea. Go to page number 1040, footnote number 8. Oh, swabhavikasya iti. Astuva pushpasya swabhavikah shukratvadigunah. Or astuva pushpasya swabhavikah shukratvadigunah. Let this whiteness etc. may be the nature of the flower. Tathapi nasau swabhavikah viyoge dushtantahiti. Even then, nasau swabhavikah viyoge dushtantah. Even then it is not a dushtant of a viyoga of the swabhava. Iti ahu vartikacharya. So, dravyantarachhadanadva sahajasyapyanikshanam tad dravya sankshaya yasmat purvat sahajekshanam iti. Dravyantara-achhadanatva, if a thing is covered by some other dravya, you know, is covered, like there is some white dust which covers this flower, you know, and then the red color completely becomes completely covered. Dravyantara-achhadanatva sahajasyabhi anikshanam, then you will not be able to see anikshanam, not be able to see what is this nature also, it gets covered by something. Tad dravya saṅśaya yasmāt, and then again the dust goes away. Puruvat sahajekṣaṇam, then you can see the original nature again. So therefore it is not an association, disassociation. Puṣpa śruktatvasya svabhāvikasyāpi dravyāntarena chinnatvāt adruṣṭihi na sattvājatehetumha tad dravya. So that whiteness actually is though. So now what Bhaktikara says is that, now they say that, see, we have changed the color from white to red. So we have changed the nature of the flower from white to red. Bhaktikara says you have not changed it. If white was the nature of the flower, even when it appears red, it is still white only. The red is an agantuka, red is something that is dravyantara, is at the time covering the white. And therefore you don't see the whiteness, but the flower remains only white. And if by some process you can remove those red atoms or whatever particles, then again the whiteness will become revealed. See, puṣpa śuklatvasya svabhāvikasyāpi dravyāntarena chinnatvāt adruṣṭihi. So now you don't see the whiteness of the flower, you see red. The whiteness is seen not because it is not there, but because it is covered by the red atoms or red particles, therefore the whiteness is not seen adruṣṭihi. Na asatvaditi, not that whiteness is gone. So we are saying that even by this process you are not changing the nature. Their example is that the flower which is white by nature, its color, its nature has been changed, that it has been made red. We say that that has not happened. Only whiteness is covered by the red particles. If those red particles can be removed, then whiteness will become evident again. So chinnatvāta drushtihi na asatvāt. You cannot see something because either it is not there or because it is covered. Here you can't see whiteness because it is covered, not because it is not there. So tad dravya saṅkṣaya yasmāt puruvat sahajekṣaṇam. Since we find that when the dravya goes away, we can see the thing as before. The example, drśyatehi vastrādau haridrādehi haridradi ragavagame yatha puram shuklatvam. Like you take the white cloth and you color it with haridra. Haridra means with red color or with turmeric, you know. Turmeric also makes it red. Ragadi apagame, when the turmeric goes away, then the cloth is seen white again. So when the cloth is yellow and you don't see that whiteness, it is not that the cloth has changed into yellow. Not that the nature of whiteness has changed into yellow, but whiteness is merely concealed or covered by the yellow, and then the yellow particles go away, the whiteness gets revealed. Therefore, even the example that you are giving of a white flower being turned into red is not the right example, because there also the nature is not changed. So, svabhavikasya sati vastu, that is what is meant here, that vastuva, astuva puṣpasya svabhavika śukratvādivana, then also the nature is not changed, it is only concealed. This is what Vatikana says. Okay, I will continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra-bhāśya-kṛtau vande bhagavantau punah punah Īśvaro guru-rātmeti मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ॐ। मृत्युरूपाणि निषदाढ़िमादेहेव वृद्धनेकंशवत्वं विज्ञास्य सुतबौद्धस्य सर्वं क्षणिकं क्षणिकं सर्वं दुःखं दुःखं सर्वं शून्यं शून्यं। मीनिंग देयर बाय दैट दि क्षणिकत्वं दुःखं शून्यत्वं ऑल ऑफ दीज आर दि धर्मास और दि एट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ विज्ञानम। दैट मीन्स दैट विज्ञान इज ऑल दीज डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स और अंश। Nachidadimadeheva, how can there be all this viruddhamsa, that vijnanam is pure on one hand, at the same time it is affected by this dukkhitvam, kshanikatvam, etc. or shunyatvam? Does it mean that vijnanam possesses all these contradictory elements within itself? They say yes. So that's one argument. So like a pomegranate, you know, though, like a pomegranate fruit, that it possesses this fruit here, right? All the contradictory elements, like a part of it may be bitter, the other part may be sweet. And so also one may imagine that the vijnanam possesses, in case, if this is the argument, says that cannot be so. Svachavhasasvabhavyat, because you yourself claim that vijnanam is svachavhasasvabhavam, by nature it is pure, placid. Anitya dukkhadinam vijnanam sattvejasati anubhuyamanatvat. The anityatvam, dukkhatvam, etc., if all of these are supposed to be vijnana amsha, then all of them are experienced, if they are experienced anubhuyamanatvat vyatirikta vishayatva prasanga. Whatever is experienced is always different from, you know. So another thing is that if they are experienced, they must be different from vijnanam. Vyatirikta vijnana vyatirikta vishayatva prasanga. Because if you accept the difference between dharma and the dharmi, ek shanikatvam, etc., the dharma and the vijnanam is the dharmi, the locus of these dharmas, then all of these, and if they are known, then the vijnanam becomes the pramanam, or the means by which they are illumined, and all these kshanikatva, etc., become the dharma which are illumined, which are prameya. So vijnanam becomes pramanam, the means with which they are illumined. These become prameya, that which are illumined. And prameya must be different from pramanam. Therefore, all kshanikatma, etc., in as much as they are known, will fall in the category of something different from vijnanam itself. Then they cannot be the amsha. Atha nitya dukkha adhyatmakatvam eva vijnanasya. You say, no, it's not that anityatma, etc., the dharma of the vijnanam, they are the very nature of vijnanam. Tada tad yogat vishuddhi kalpana anupattihi. Then you can never understand or accept a viyoga of this swarupa, and therefore that vijnanam can become vishuddham. So by getting rid of this anityatva or whatever it is, that there can be pure vijnanam, this cannot be, because this is the very nature. Sanyogi mala viyogadhi vishuddhir bhavati. What is meant by vishuddhi or purification is sanyogi mala viyogad. Mala or impurity which has somehow come into association sanyoga. So when there is viyoga or disassociation with that impurity, then that is what we call purity. Vishuddhir bhavati yatha adarsha prabhutinam. Just as in case of mirror, etc. So when there is dust on the mirror, by removal of dust, that the mirror becomes clean. Because the dust is not part of the mirror, it is incidental. This swabhavikena dharmena kasyachit viyoga drushtaha. But you can never find that something can be disassociated with dharma or with its own swarupa. This swabhavikena dharmena. So that which is one's own nature, there cannot be disassociation from that. Nahi agnehe swabhavikena prakashena aushnena va viyoga drushtaha. Just as with the fire, we can never see a disassociation either with the light or heat, because light and heat are the fire. यदि पुष्पगुणानां रक्तत्वादीनां द्रव्यांतरयोगेण वियोजनं दृश्यते.
सो सम काइंड ऑफ एन एग्जांपल दे हैव
एज टू हाउ फ्लावर पुष्पगुणानां रक्तत्वादीनां और शुक्लत्वादीनां पुष्पगुणानां शुक्लत्वादीनां लाइक व्हाइटनेस एटसेट्रा विच इज इनहेरेंट इन इन द फ्लावर द्रव्यांतरयोगेण. सो बाय प्रोसेसिंग द सीड विथ व्हाट दे कॉल द रेड लैक that somehow the particles of this red leg of atoms must be impregnated into the seed, and that is how the seed also gains some redness, and that redness gets reflected in the flower, and so the flower which should normally be white, we find it to be red. So it seems as though the nature of flower has been changed. The flower is a nature, so white is the nature of the flower, that seems to be changed. So how do you say that you cannot change the nature? This is their argument. See, flower which is naturally white is changed to red. Yadapi pushpagunanam raktatvadinam dravyantravyogena viyojanam dushyate. So you find that even the nature of flower which is white also can be disassociated from the flower for the flower to become red.
Tatrapi sanyogapuratvam anumeyam miyate.
But there also you imagine that even that white color itself is also not inherent, that's all. If that white color can go away because of association with some red, whatever dravyantra sanyogena, the dravyantra is nothing but those the red particles or red atoms or whatever they are, which belong to some other dravya such as red lac, which now impregnated into the seed, and therefore now they find their place in flower, because of which the flower is red. Still that red is dravyantara, even though it is part of the flower apparently, but still it is dravyantara, it is another dravya. So dravyantara sanyogena vyojanam drishyate. So because of sanyoga association with another dravya, we find a disassociation of that nature as though. Although Vartikara said that we do not accept this even as an example of change of nature, because according to him, that original white color is just hidden, and this red color comes and just conceals that white color. If by some process you can again remove this red, then the white color will become evident. The example was like a cloth, which if it is soaked in turmeric becomes yellow. But the whiteness is not left. The yellow seems to cover, yellow covers the whiteness. And therefore, if that covering is removed, then whiteness is very much there. So in fact, even that is not an example of changing the nature. Even as far as flower is concerned, they do not look upon that as an example of changing the nature of flower, because that white color can be brought back by some other process when the redness can be disassociated. So as I was told, just as this flower, if this comes in contact with alcohol, you know, or whatever, it will lose its color. And so, if it loses a color, that means that it was not inherent to begin with. Somehow there was an association of that color with an object, and that alone disassociation is possible. This association is not possible unless association was there. Therefore, tatravi sanyoga purvatvam anumiyate. There also, so if that white color, red color, whatever color has gone away, being replaced by something else, that means that it was not inherent to begin with, it was by some association earlier also. This is how we are inferring. So, in the page 1039, Anandagiri said in the last line, Vimatam Sanyoga Purvakam Vibhagvathat Soho Mesha Adivata. And soho Vimatam. What is Vimatam? Vyuktam Raktatvadi. That raktatva, etc., which leaves that flower, sanyoga purukam, so it must be there as a result of sanyoga to begin with, vibhagavatvata, because we find it to be separated. Meshadivata, like the sheep or the rams, they get associated, separated. And so that separation shows that there was an association, so they can't be separated.
इदनुमानात् न स्वाभाविकस्य सति वस्तुनि नाशास्ति इत्यर्थः. And therefore, स्वाभाविकस्य वस्तुनि,
So, what is svabhavikam? What is inherent? What is natural? Nasha nasti. There cannot be nasha or destruction or disassociation of that which is natural. As we saw the footnote number 8, this is which we read already yesterday, svabhavikasyadi astuva pushpasya svabhavikah shuklatvadigunah tathapi nasau svabhavikavyoge drishtandahiti. Even though you accept whiteness as the svabhav of the flower and the flower is found to be red, we do not say that the flower is disassociated from whiteness. So even though now the flower appears to be red, still we do not say that it is disassociated from whiteness, because whiteness is very much there. This is the idea here. Dravyantara chadanadva sahajasyavi anikshanam. But when the red goes away, I don't know how to say that, you know. When the red, let us say, goes away, because of other association with alcohol, you know, the atoms of alcohol, whatever happens to red, I guess some chemical reaction takes place, and therefore, so whatever it is that is responsible for redness here, which is moisture, I guess, pigments get dissolved in the alcohol, that's all. Yeah. So we have to say that red color is association only, whatever the color is. And whatever color comes or remains after this red this orange is removed, then that must be the color, the original color of flower, we have to imagine, you know. So that must be the original thing. And that's the reason why when the moisture gets evaporated, the color slowly and slowly fades away, you know. And so it fades away, that means that it was there as an association. And everything is colorless to begin with. I don't know, this poor flower. So whatever color the flower has is concealed right now because of association with this color, rose color. And so when that disassociation happens, the original thing comes back. This is what you would imagine. Dravyantara chadanadva sahajasyapi anikshanam tad dravya sankshaya yasmad. So when that dravya is sankshya, purvavat sahaja ekshanam, then we can see its original color as before. Now we are on the page 1040. Anumana anugunam pratyaksham darshayati. Pratyaksham darshayati. Now, Vashyakara shows our practical experience. Anugunam, in keeping with anumanam, in inference. The earlier inference was that, so, vimatam sanyoga purvakam vyogatvat. Vyogatvat, because there is vyoga or disassociation, therefore, the earlier was an association and not an inherent nature. Mesha adivat, whatever disassociates must have associated and may not be inherently together, but that is inherently part of it, or the nature of it rather. That anumana, tat anugunam pratyaksham darshayati. So pratyaksham, our practical experience, which is in keeping with anumanam, is what is shown by Bhashyakara, Bijayati. So let us read that Bhashya, Bijaya. Bija bhavanaya pushpa phaladina gunantarotpatti darshanat. Bija bhavanaya, bhavana, impregnation, I guess, you know, something. So some by subjecting this seed to a particular process. Footnote number 1, vasanaya, bija vasanaya. So that vasana, or that inherent samskara in the bija. Pushpa phaladinam gunantarotpatti darshanat. So bija has some samskaras, when those samskaras change because of association with some dravya, like red lac in this case, pushpa phaladinam, then pushpa also is found to be a different color, phala also, I don't know, phaladinam, gunantarotpatti darshanat. So gunantarotpatti, normally whatever guna is there in that pushpa or phala, gunantara, some other guna, we find in the pushpa and the phala, some other guna. So, says Anandagiri, कार्पासादि बीजे द्रव्य विशेष संपर्काद रक्तादि वासनया तत्पुष्पादीनाम रक्तादि गुणोदयोपलम्भात्।
Now, so all these kind of agriculture experiments must have been going on those days also.
Karpasadi bije,
and so cotton,
and the cotton seed.
Dravya vishesha samparka, footnote number 9.
Alakta adi dravya miti bhavaha.
Alakta means again that lakh, red lakh.
So dravya vishesha samparka,
on account of samparka or association with this red lakh,
Raktadivasanaya,
again footnote number 10, Raktadivasanaya. That's why the footnote 1 said Vasana.
Raktatvadi ashrayibhuta sukshma avayava samparkena diyavada.
Raktatvadi ashrayibhuta sukshma avayava. Avaya sukshma avayava is like particle, fine particles or atoms.
Raktatvadi ashrayibhuta.
Even that atom also is an ashraya, is locus of red color such as red, etc.
Tat samparkena, on account of samparka or the contact with that, the atoms,
which are the locus of color such as red.
So raktadi vasana,
that's how the vasana. So here it is,
raktadi vasana yadi raktatvadi ashrayabhuta sukshma avayava samparkena.
So by samparka or association with these fine particles which are red in color or which are the locus of the red color, because they also are locus of the red color.
Tat pushpadinam karpasa pushpadinam raktadi gunodayo apalambhat.
When you find that the cotton flower is red, so this is a matter of research. I have never come across this, but
so raktadi gunodayo apalambhat. Tat sanyogi dravya.
Footnote number 12. Tat sanyogi, not yet, but tat sanyogi dravya.
Bijadi paramparaya pushpadi sanyogi dravyam.
What happens is the real sanyoga association happens with the seed. But through the association with the seed, then there happens association with flower also. In sequence.
So bijadi paramparaya. Red comes to the seed, then goes to, I guess, the stem, and then goes to the flower, and then we go to the fruit, So, paramparaya. So, this is how bijadi paramparaya, pushpadi sanyogi dravyam.
And so, that is how the red atoms of the lac, they get associated with pushpa, through the seed.
Raktatvadi ashrayibhuta sukshma avayavakyam.
And so those fine particles which are red in color, dravyantra sanyogena, so that is the sanyoga. So that is dravyantra. Those red particles of red leg are other dravya, and by sanyoga with them, that the flower, etc., they also change in color.
Tat avagama deva ityarthaha.
So this is what we find. So that redness in the flower is due to the redness in the seed, which again is due to the contact with the red substance.
So going back to Angi, tat pushpadinam raktadi gunode upalambhad tat sanyogi dravya apagamadeva.
And when that sanyogi dravya apagama happens,
tat pushpadishu raktatvadi apagapihi
yasaukta karpasadishu
raktatvadi apagapihi.
Then there is apagati. Then also there is a going away, disassociation of the redness. How does that happen? I don't know. So let's say that the cotton flower is now found to be red. So how do you disassociate the red from that cotton flower? I don't know. But then you can get it back. That white thing can come back again in white color. So however that happens, I do not know. But first of all, whether cotton flower can be red itself is the question. Red get the cotton flower? Oh, okay. So then that's all right. Then it must be made. They must know how to make it white also. By some process like alcohol, whatever it is. So if that disassociation happens, it may become white again. Bleaching. So bleaching process.
So in fact, dyeing process and bleaching process is what it amounts to in effect. Vishuddhi anupatti upasamharati.
In short,
there cannot be Vishuddhi from that which cannot bring about a change in the very nature. If change or disassociation is brought about, then we would infer that there was an association to begin with, and that it was not his inherent nature to begin with. Therefore, if you say that this anityatvam, or that is kshanikatvam, dukkhatvam, shunyatvam, all of this is nature of vijnanam, that is, his impurities are nature of vijnanam, that you can never hope to purify them because you cannot change the nature. That's all. You can change everything.